On November 21st, 1960, a solitary helicopter soared above the rugged peaks of the Himalayas, defying the thin air and treacherous winds at nearly 20,000 feet. This was the Aérospatiale Alouette III, piloted by the renowned French aviator Jean Boulet. Amidst the snow-covered mountains, Boulet skillfully maneuvered the helicopter, performing takeoffs and landings in an extreme environment where few dared to venture. But its capabilities don't stop there. The Alouette III was also the first helicopter ever to be capable of deploying anti-tank missiles and light torpedoes, providing the French Navy with its first helicopter offering real offensive power. From the highest and coldest of mountains to the semi-desert regions, whether launching missile strikes or rescuing beleaguered forces, the Alouette III light utility helicopter could do it all over the world. In the mid-1950s, the aviation world witnessed a revolution with the introduction of the soared aviation Alouette II, the first production turbine-powered helicopter. It shattered multiple world records and achieved global commercial success. However, this wasn't enough. The visionaries at soared aviation were already dreaming bigger. Since its inception, the manufacturers have been greatly interested in the development of derivatives and, most importantly, further advancement in the relatively recent field of rotorcraft. In accordance with these goals, top management at the company decided to gather a design team, led by René Mouille, with significant contributions from Charles Marchetti, along with top technicians, to develop a larger, wider, more powerful, and more efficient helicopter. After getting formal approval and the necessary funds, between 1957 and 58, the group immediately got to work on two prototypes of the new model, initially designated as the SE-3160. The new helicopter was later christened Alouette III, the French equivalent of Skylark, and the group completed the first prototype by the beginning of 1959. The results were outstanding. The Alouette III, crafted by soared aviation, is a single-engine light utility helicopter with a standard configuration heavily inspired by its predecessor, the Alouette II. This new model features a turbomeca Astazou 14 turboshaft engine producing 660 shaft horsepower, allowing it to reach a top speed of 130 miles per hour and a cruising speed of 115 miles per hour. Designed for versatility, the Alouette III boasts a range of 292 miles and an impressive service ceiling of nearly 20,000 feet. It measures 33 feet in length, weighs 2,474 pounds empty, and has a maximum takeoff weight of 4,850 pounds. The airframe features a cabin at the front and a tail boom at the rear, along with larger diameter main and tail rotors and a new transmission system. While typically equipped with tricycle landing gear, the Alouette III can be fitted with floats or skis for water or snow landings to land wherever it's needed. With a payload capacity of up to 1,650 pounds, the Alouette III can be armed with various weapons, including a pintle-mounted 7.62mm machine gun, a 20mm cannon, anti-tank missiles, rocket pods, and Mark 44 torpedoes for maritime operations. Compared to its predecessor, the Alouette III offers a much more spacious cabin. It can accommodate up to 6 passengers, or 2 litter patients and a couple of medical assistants, in addition to the pilot. As a military aerial ambulance, the helicopter is equipped with simple, easy-to-install equipment for the rapid setup and transport of 2 stretcher patients, 1 less-injured seated casualty, and a doctor. The rear doors can hinge upward to facilitate loading. In civilian service, the Alouette III typically transports a single stretcher patient who can receive medical assistance during flight. For search and rescue missions in mountainous regions or at sea, the helicopter can be equipped with an air-operated hoist on the left side of the cabin. This setup allows for 3 people to be hoisted into the cabin in succession. In contrast to aerial ambulance settings, the left rear portion of the cabin floor can hinge downward to facilitate the operation of the rescue hoist. On February 28, 1959, the first prototype of the Alouette III took to the skies, piloted by the skilled French aviator Jean Boulet. For the helicopter's flight test program, soared aviation devised a series of rigorous exercises to push every feature to its limit. Time and again, the Alouette III surpassed expectations. Just a few months after its maiden flight, in June 1959, an Alouette III achieved an extraordinary feat. Carrying 7 people, it successfully performed takeoffs and landings in the French Alps at an incredible altitude of 15,780 feet, an unprecedented accomplishment for a helicopter at the time. In November 1960, the same helicopter demonstrated its capabilities once more. With a crew of two and a payload of 551 pounds, it executed takeoffs and landings in the Himalayas at nearly 20,000 feet, solidifying the company's and the Alouette III's reputation for performance in extreme conditions. These remarkable records, both achieved by Jean Boulet, were heavily publicized by Soared Aviation, significantly boosting the helicopter's sales. That same year, the Alouette III officially entered serial production with an initial order of 50 aircraft, marking its introduction into service. The Aérospatiale Alouette III was groundbreaking as the first helicopter in the world to use anti-tank missiles, specifically the SS-11 MCOLS wire-guided missile. It also revolutionized naval capabilities by carrying light torpedoes, providing the Navy with its first helicopter offering real offensive power. Designed and proven to fly at high altitudes, the Alouette III quickly earned a worldwide reputation. According to its manufacturer, it was the first helicopter to offer effective multi-mission capability, excelling in both civil and military roles with its diverse performance range. For decades, the Alouette III served France across the globe, from the mainland to New Caledonia and the French Antilles. These helicopters performed a myriad of roles, fighting narcotic smugglers, gathering intelligence, conducting medical evacuations, and winching people from the sea. Each overseas detachment included a helicopter, two fully qualified pilots, a third pilot fresh from flight school, and up to seven mechanics. The Alouette III also left a significant mark in training. Initially, new pilots found the helicopter complex and delicate. However, they soon realized it was, as one veteran pilot put it, quote, a moped with a big luggage rack. The model's readiness and reliability were legendary. During a posting in Martinique in the Caribbean, only one flight was canceled in nearly 3 months of operation. Impressed by its performance, the French Army ordered 50 Alouette IIIs in the summer of 1971. The French Navy also utilized 37 helicopters over the years in two main versions. The SA-316B, some equipped for instrument flying and aircrew training, and the more powerful SA-319B, intended for Tourville-class anti-submarine warfare frigates. A total of 1,437 Alouette IIIs were produced in Marignan, France, from 1961 to 79. Production of the SE-3160 model continued until 1968, when the SE-316B variant took over. The final French-produced Alouette III was delivered in 1985. However, license production continued in other countries, extending its operational lifetime. Despite the production line's closure back in France, this did not mean the end of the Alouette III. In fact, well over 500 helicopters have been manufactured under license abroad in several countries, such as Argentina, Australia, Austria, Chile, Denmark, Pakistan, Portugal, South Korea, Switzerland, and more. One of the largest fleets of the type after France is India. With a licensing arrangement beginning in 1962 with Hindustan Aeronautics Limited, the nation has built more than 300 rotorcraft under the name. The HAL Chetak, like its French sibling, has served various mission roles through the decades, including anti-tank, training, transport, casualty evacuation, communications, and liaison roles. India's HAL Chetak has returned time and time again to the challenging terrains of the Himalayas, where the type has become an invaluable asset during both peacetime and conflict. During the Indo-Pakistani Wars of 1965 and again in 1971, the Chetak played a crucial role in transporting troops and supplies to these remote and high-altitude locations. While the Chetak began to be gradually replaced by the newer HAL Drove helicopter in the armed forces in the 2010s, with more than 300 units, the company has continued to independently update and adapt the helicopters to the nation's needs over the decades. With this, a modernized variant of the Chetak helicopter has remained in production, though at a diminished volume, well into the 21st century. As of 2017, while the Indian Navy reportedly recognized the need to procure a replacement for the type, that same year, she became the most widely used Indian Air Force helicopter for training, light utility, and light attack roles. The latest HAL Chetak was delivered in 2021 and also included updated state-of-the-art avionics. Nearly 400 models have been built since 1986. Perhaps the most extensive combat use of the Alouette III occurred with the South African Air Force, or SAAF, where it served for over 44 years after 121 examples were acquired between 1962 and 1975 from France. The Alouette's primary role was qualifying helicopter pilots and flight engineers for the SAAF, along with secondary roles in search and rescue, and most importantly, supporting internal stability in South Africa. In 1966, with a fleet of around 50 Alouette IIIs, several were dispatched to support ground troops in Southwest Africa against the emerging Southwest African People's Organization, or SWAPO. This marked the start of the lengthy South African border war, characterized by guerrilla warfare, significant international involvement, and Cold War tensions. For its service during the so-called Bush War, the helicopter was adapted into the G-car and K-car configurations. The G-car served as a troop transport, while the K-car was armed with a powerful 20mm cannon. From the summer of 1967 onwards, the K-car Alouette III served as a support platform for South African counter-strike operations inside neighboring Namibia and Angola. It was used to engage enemy positions, suppress enemy fire, and protect friendly troops during operations. The helicopter's agility and ability to hover also made it an ideal platform for reconnaissance and surveillance missions, allowing the South African Defense Force, or SADF, to gather critical intelligence on enemy movements and positions. The aircraft excelled in the harsh African conditions. Pilots and crew admired it, enemies dreaded it, and those rescued from mountain ledges or flood-stricken regions saw it as a lifesaver. Amongst pilots and other service members, it was said that if you could hover the Alouette, you could hover any other helicopter. It even had its own nickname, Dret Car, which translates to wire car in English, referencing the helicopter's practical and rugged nature. By the end of the conflict in 1989, reportedly a total of 8 Alouette IIIs were listed as lost. Throughout its service life with the South African Air Force, the Alouette III fleet accumulated more than 346,000 flight hours. Finally, in 2006, the last Alouette III was officially withdrawn from service. In the summer of 2004, after 32 years of service, most Alouette IIIs were retired from the French Air Force after being replaced by the much more modern twin-engine Eurocopter EC-355 Écureuil II. Meanwhile, the French Army also withdrew the last of their examples in 2013. The retirement was mainly motivated by a lack of new features that would be present in contemporary models. By 2017, the French Navy still used the Alouette III, albeit in a very reduced capacity, for search and rescue and logistics missions. By then, it was costing the service more than twice the equivalent costs of a modern-day rotorcraft in its class, a side effect of the fleet's advanced age and an overall shortage of spare parts for a type no longer in production. Finally, on December 9, 2022, a special ceremony was held, where a few dozen veterans watched the last three Alouette IIIs still in service with the French Navy take their final flight. The Aérospatiale Alouette III embodied the triumphant France of the 1960s, a nation with a robust, sovereign, and innovative industry. During its peak, when the Alouette III roamed the skies, the French Navy was a dominant force, boasting 2 aircraft carriers, around 40 well-armed frigates and corvettes, and about 20 submarines. The retirement of the last three Alouette IIIs, numbers 997, 161, and 302, from a fleet boasting only half the numbers of its glory days, marks the end of a magnificent era.